And speaking of infra, IL&FS Group is gearing to make its presence more prominent across the infrastructure sector after raising $1 billion from Industrial and Commercial Bank of China last month to fund infrastructure-related activities. It is now scouting for funds to multiply its renewable energy portfolio. In an exclusive conversation with the company's vice chairman, Hari Sankaran, CNBC TV18's Manasvi Gelani quizzes him on banks' cutting infra exposure, government's rationale behind toll exemptions, and company's future fundraising plans. Here's a slice of that exclusive conversation.
A lot of banks who have exposures to infrastructure are looking to, you know, either cut down their exposures or looking at ways of exiting in some way or the other. Does that worry you?
It does. And let me explain to you what I mean when I say it does. I think we need to have a better way of offering projects to the private sector than has been the case in the past. It is not good for a bidding process to generate a frenzy amongst the private sector to bid for jobs. It would typically lead to an overpricing of opportunity and therefore impose much greater risks on the financing institutions that come into that particular opportunity.
But your company seems to have mastered that art, because recently I was reading, you all have managed to back two projects in Madhya Pradesh, considering all of the lowest bidders. So how, what is working for you and not for the rest?
I don't know what's not working for other people. I tell you what's working for us. I think we need to be extremely conservative. We need to price risks. And we need to make sure that we can implement the project when we win it.
You know, exemptions. Government is going to make up for the shortfall, right? So, I mean, how has your experience been by far with the government?
Let me put it this way. If a concession said that I can charge toll and for 30 years to recover my investment, and the government at some point in the middle comes along and says, now don't charge toll, but I will now make the payment to you directly, I think that reflects lack of contractual certainty.
In fact, your company was looking to sell some of your operational projects to pension funds. I mean, has that gone through?
It's an ongoing process for us.
Okay.
We have a number of projects in operations phase, de-risked, which are available for those investors who would like less risks.
But recently, have you closed any transaction?
I think we have a couple of transactions.
Okay, so at least can you tell us number of projects that have been closed?
I think one or two.
Solar mission. I mean, you know, we're going really big on it. The government's been gung-ho about it. You know, a lot of banks, I understand, that after the announcement of this big mission, set aside corpuses specific to this industry segment. Does your company also look at doing that, or have you already done that?
Absolutely.
Okay.
We are looking forward to building a very large portfolio, both in wind and solar.
Okay.
We already have a fairly large portfolio in wind.
What is your existing portfolio like?
About 750 megawatts of operational assets.
Okay. And going forward, is it going to be as much?
Easily.
Okay. And more than that?
Much more than that.
Okay. Double of that?
I would hope much more than double.
Okay. So are you already bidding for something like that?
We've just finished a 40 megawatt solar farm
in
Madhya Pradesh under the bid process. And we're looking to be as aggressive as we can within our conservative framework of pricing.
Roughly how much capital would you need to get going?
IL&FS Energy, depending on the number of megawattage it wants to go for, would obviously require lots of capital.
What is that number in your mind that you're looking to raise?
It's about 1,000 crores.
In fact, IL&FS Engineering was up by over 1.5% at the back of that interview that we broke today on CNBC TV18.